Today I have an interesting thing. If you don't mind me shifting gears, I have both. These are both of my premium razors, the Philharmonica and the Fawn. I just honed them. I honed them almost exactly the same way I did the Bismarck. So I want to... Okay, so we're doing that. I'm just gonna shave, man. I got about 2 days growth. Feels pretty scruffy to me. And then I'm just gonna shave. And afterwards I'm gonna make a comparison and I'm gonna show you something kind of startling. Okay. I'm doing two razors at one time because I don't want to make another video. I'm tired of making these videos on this thing. Today I'm gonna be shaving with the Gaelic Tweed series. This is the shave oil. I don't usually use shave oil because it's kind of hard to get off your hands. But the scent is just out of this world. So I had a good chat with Mr. Campbell last night. 2 hours conversation. That guy is great. That guy's great, man. You know, he's real. And he knows what he's talking about, too. So, alright, so I got the soap blooming, and the bloom water is really milky. So, I'm going to do something else that I never do. Put the bloom water on my face. I don't know what is necessary, but I do know one thing. It probably helps to keep your face hydrated as you're lathering your soap. Today I'm using my scrubby, the Bronco brush, and away we go. Ah, load it like you want to abuse it. I gotta come up with my own sayings, man. Good. Okay. Right now, it kind of promises to be a little bit of a loose lather. The scent is really nice on this soap. I also got the aftershave I'm going to use too. So, I held these two razors last night. And what it is just going back to what you know works and using that as a starting point. So there's my lather. Man, nice and creamy and sweet. Today's Friday, mama's coming home soon. I just got off the roof at Clean the Flu. First time I let someone do it was $60 and like 10 minutes, seriously. He took 20 because he dicked around up there. But I bought the brush. I don't even know how much. It wasn't that expensive, but it doesn't matter because every time I clean the flu, which is 3 times a year, I save $60. And I get to do it my way. If I see anything wrong, or if anything happens, it's on me. So I got that done. 10 minutes. And I mean 10 minutes from going from leaving the back door, going out, grabbing 2 tools, a brush and 2 poles, and put my extension ladder onto the house, and up and then back down, put everything away. 10 literal minutes. It's pretty good. All right, so I'm gonna start, I'm gonna do the Fawn on the right side. I'm just drying my hands off. Freshly honed, freshly stropped. This is one gorgeous razor here. As you can see, it says Fawn. Right there. Okay, so enough screwing around. Let's get it on. Smooth. Man, it's almost Christmas time. You know what I did? I ordered a damn Atoma 1200. And it said it'll be here by the 24th of December. I says, oh, cool. And so I ordered it. And I was looking at the details today. That thing's coming all the way from Japan. It's not going to get here by the 24th. I think I've been ganked. I missed you. I missed you, my lovely. Sometimes I shave, and then I kind of startle myself thinking I'm shaving with my left hand. Now, I'll tell you, man, these two razors are just, you know, top of the line. They just really are. You know, I mean, how do you top them? I mean, I'm going to show you something. I'm going to show you the wear on this spine on this Philharmonica. Can you see it? Can you see that flat spot? That's wear. That's you know, that's wear, and this thing still shaves supremely. And in a minute, I'm going to be asking the question, why? Yesterday when I shaved, or the day before, whatever it was, when I shaved with the Bismarck, I said, I did my first pass, and I said, you can't judge the razor by its first pass. I was wrong about that. I was like being too optimistic. Guarantee that. So, back to the Fawn. All right, so. Oh yeah, look at that. You know, it seems really that, you know, if you have a good sharp razor, it'll glide over your skin. That's what I'm noticing. Because that's one thing I noticed with the Bismarck. Because, I don't know, whoever's been following me, I don't know. Maybe no one's following me, I don't know. Because, when I said that I was, it was getting hung up on the hairs, and I was going this direction, I believe, and that his mark was getting hung up on the hairs, right? Yeah, so, no. You have to judge your razor by its first pass. This is the Philly. guarantee you right now that this shave, the way I'm doing it, I'm not going to be able to tell which side of the face I use which razor on. I can guarantee that because they are cutting outstanding. I can't wait to review my little secret. I just look so much better. Oh, you have one more pass left, man. Look at that. Man, I just feel like $100, man. It's nice. So, all right. Add a little water to it. It's nice and glossy. So it's going to be a good Christmas, I think. Probably the best one in a long time. There's been some things happening that I didn't like for so many years. It was upsetting to me. And finally, I called the person on it because the person didn't want to take hints. And finally, it came to a head. And you know, no matter what you do, who you deal with, what kind of videos you put out, you know, you got to do them with love. Because if you don't do them with love, do things with love, then you're just a loud noise. This is going to be a sweet shave. And I'm telling you, man, I'm baffled right now. You'll see what I'm talking about. But I'm baffled. Now the Fawn razor. Ah, I love the scent of that. I got to get closer, man, because my eyes are going. I'm kind of old. Getting old. There's no water on this, or put it away. I need to clean that razor. I got the slurry dust on there. So, all right, I'm gonna take this all off real quick. So, I'm going to end this video in a couple seconds, but I've got to show you guys something. And I think I have a solution. See, that's what happens when you experiment. You come up with your solutions. When you come up with your solutions, then you come up with a pattern of doing things that you can repeat over and over again and get good results. Suicide Blonde. Yeah, I remember my sons when they were about 15, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 20. Lots of fun. We always had a lot of fun. I wouldn't trade those memories for anything in the world. All right, so here is the test. Perfect, man. Perfect shave from each razor. Ooh, I got a secret to tell you. I don't have a sponsor today. In the middle of the day. I don't drink so much anymore. I kind of quit because it's just become a hassle in my life. Actually, I think I'm going to use... where is it? Okay, there's that. Okay, so... So cold water, rinse. Boom. No stinging. Not even on the mustache here, so that is seriously good news. That is the way I judge a razor sometimes. Not completely, but you know, if I get that, that's a cherry on top. If I get no sting from the Alum bar, and that is a cherry on top of my shave, and I'd like the cherry. All right, so put a little bit of witch hazel on. Man, so smooth. Wow, so smooth. All right, now the piece. La Resistance. Get a tweet after shave. What shaving products? I do like their stuff. I haven't visited Lee's store in a long time, though. No stinging? Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, that's good. That is really super good. It's like, you know, when you get a good shave and you put on something really nice, it's just, you know, especially when you get the cherry on top. Wow. All right, so here's a dilemma. It's a dilemma. Well, it's not so much of a... Ooh, that stuff's making me cough a little bit. Great sheet. All right, so... this is what I got here, okay? I measured the Bismarck, and the blade was 17.48 millimeters thick, wide, on the profile. The spine thickness was 5.9. Now, the Fawn and the Filly both measured 20.9 millimeters wide in the profile. And the Filly was 7.20 in the spine, thickness of the spine. And the Fawn was 6.40. Okay, I don't expect you all to memorize it, but here's what it looks like. I think I'll just take a picture of this and put it on the video. Now, this is the kicker, man. Okay, the Bismarck's bevel angle is 19.43. Okay, keep that in mind, 19.43. The Fawn bevel angle... it's 18.21. Now, The Philly bevel angle is 19.71. The Bismarck is right in the middle. The Bismarck is right in the middle. And this Philly has been shaving good for a long time, and you've seen the spine wear. Now, here's the secret. I think it's a secret. The only thing I changed was when I honed the Bismarck, I went 5K, 8K, right? Type didn't shave very good. When I honed the Philly and the Fawn Razor, I went 5K, 8K, 12K slurry, 12K clear. And that, I think, is going to become part of my progress. I would like to get a stone that's bigger than the 12K that I got. It's just like, they're kind of dinky. Anyway, that's it. No big deal, huh? You'll take care, man. And remember, even if you got a good shave and there's a surprise waiting over there, it's always a good day to slick your hair back and go out with mama on a Friday night. You'll take care, man. Later.